Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, we're gonna paint this nice little cloud lightning scene here. So this is the palette that we're gonna use, six colors. After a quick mixing process, we start to build up the base layer, first layer of color. And yeah, I try to apply the color very thick in this case. I didn't use any thinner, any oil. Basically get the whole white of the canvas covered. Already establishing the shape of the clouds roughly in the first go. These are now brushes for the second layer, and as you can see, very soft brushes. Small ones, bigger ones. Yeah, and I start to put in the brightest bluish color, and directly after that I start to establish the darkest tone that we have here. It's basically in this stage here I try to follow my own first layer of color and flesh it out more or less, trying to establish the colors. I'm putting them on where they should be, and this looks pretty rough, pretty not very painterly, but this is really, I think this way it's much easier when you try to put in the colors. I mean, those windows like this purplish light color here on the left side here, putting this one in first, make sure it's on the right spot. And then I start to blend colors. In this place here I use smaller brush first, then I go in with the bigger blender brush and give the whole cloud shape. And now this 3D look that you need to imply to make it look realistic. Yeah, so I basically build up the whole thing, putting in the colors, those important colors to establish where they need to be, and go around them with the bluish color, cooler color here. This purple color is basically the level behind this cloud that we paint, and on this level we basically have these lightnings that we're gonna paint later on. That's basically just putting on the colors, blending, and of course doing some fine blending here. And this basically is just the second layer that we put on. And here now I put in some more details. We need some more details on the lower side of the cloud here. It looked a bit too flat, in my opinion. And also the reference said so. Yeah, so basically I put on a bit darker color over the still wet color that we have here. And try also to establish again this roundness of the clouds that we have here. And this is another key factor when it comes to painting clouds. You need to put in these volumes. You basically need to put in the roundness of the clouds. And do this by treating the cloud like a round shape. And by doing this you achieve a very realistic build-up of the volume of the clouds. There is a more finer details here, the smaller brush. I note this color here, the purplish color is still wet, so you need to take care about the amount of color that you put on. If you use too much color, then this process might become a bit too difficult. Of course, I'm blending after this. Some more details. Now we're gonna paint the tree part, forest part, lower end. On the right side, I do it basically just with a dry brush technique, letting the green of the forest shine through. And on the foreground, I establish the rough shape and also try to get in those finer details on top part to make it look realistic and give it some more detail. Now to the important part here. Lightning strikes the behalf here. This layer here is now finished and dry. Then I start to dry brush on the background, the color in the back of the lightnings. I see this is a very difficult and delicate process, that because you need to put in the color very, very thin. The brush has nearly no color on it. And you also need to alter the color, get a bit darker, and really watch the amount of color that you have on the brush. This is, I think, the most important thing here. I better go too thin than too thick on the first try. You see, I basically pulled the color off with my fingers, and then I start to build up the first lightnings that appear here. Also not yet complete white, and also toying around with the thickness of the color. See here I'm getting a bit much thinner, the color. And then I finally mix the color for the center lightning here. This is nearly pure titanium white, as you can see. And I basically put this layer of color over the still wet corona color that we put in first, this little purplish color here. We have beneath this lightning here. And of course we need some extensions from this lightning stroke here. And for this color, I go a bit darker. Also a bit thinner, the color itself, as you can see. And some more lightning strikes. And then you see me going back, putting in more of this corona thing around the lightning strike. Also again with the dry brush technique, and a very, very dry brush. And the key is really to use hardly any color on the brush. A very, very dry brush you need to take here. Adding some more lightnings here and there. Toying around with the color, brightness, darkness. And then I finally start to dry brush blend some places where I think the cloud and the Lightning needs to be a bit softer. Yeah, then we're finished. So you like this little Cloud Pending tutorial? I got here a lot more about this topic.